Subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get all the latest updates.
One of the weirdest things which we have heard here in Goa in any of the hospitals is that the oxygen pressure would drop between 2 to 6. Now, regarding this matter, many people have gone to the court also. Many families want answer also. Why the oxygen pressure drops only between 2 to 6 a.m.? This answer no one knows. Many people allege that this is a mismanagement on the part of the hospital. But you cannot say anything. Now, we have a family. These two sisters, they lost their mother. They have just cremated her and they're here standing outside speaking to us. They have the same story to share. For 2 days, their mother was gasping for breath. Her oxygen level had dropped and the hospital could not do anything. It's the same, the time limit, the oxygen level dropping. It's the same everywhere. Ma'am, can you please brief what had happened to your mother when she was admitted and which hospital?
She was admitted on 12th, around 8 o'clock.
Okay.
On 12th of May. And then as a starting of the thing, they gave us a very good treatment. We were there and many nurses came together. Even the ward boys and all, they gave full cooperation. And they put her on oxygen, on a wheelchair with a cylinder. And after some time, like they had taken an x-ray, everything was done and she was admitted on the bed. So then my sister who is here, she managed to stay with her. And it seemed the first 2 days it was very nice, very good treatment. Huh. And suddenly on the 14th or 15th of May, she complained at around 5 o'clock that mommy's oxygen is not working. The cylinder itself is not working. The water level was not going down. So she said, like, she gave a complaint to the ward boy and she said that mommy is grasping for breath and try to do something. They would say, like, you take her to GMC. Now they would tell that she has to be taken to GMC.
But why were they saying that she needs to be shifted to GMC? Did they have a problem?
Ventilator. They were telling her there's no ventilator facility. So we said, like, we don't want to take her to GMC because we know the condition over there, what it is. And my mommy, luckily, she got oxygen as well as a bed. But then they made us to give in writing also that they will not be held responsible for all this thing in case if there is something problem about it. Okay. So my brother already signed a consent saying that we would like to keep her at ESI only. And mommy also would never like to go. Every time she would get that GMC word and she would get frightened with that word only. So she said, you take me home.
Why did she get frightened hearing the GMC hospital's name? What are the conditions? Can you elaborate your fear about getting your mother admitted to the government hospital?
Yeah, because not of government hospital, GMC, we have heard many things about it, saying even midnight and even daytime, there are no beds available.
Okay.
And there is no oxygen also, because we read the paper. And through that only we get the information, and many people who had gone, they also had told us about it, that people are sleeping down on the floor. So my mother is old, she was 81. So thinking about her thing, because by the time she slept down, she would get an attack, and she was suffering from many sicknesses before.
Okay.
She was having all those sicknesses and she was under treatment. So one day, like a full night, then she gave a complaint. She said, we will see. 1/2 day they did something. And the next day it was a problem. She could not talk. Then they said, we are shifting her to the third floor. First she was at the ground floor and then they shifted her to the third floor. That time I think they were just sleeping and all of a sudden they came and we'll go like that. I think maybe due to that, like, she was in deep sleep. Even she was sleeping in the afternoon. So all of a sudden they came with some and we'll go, come, pack up your things, we'll go. I think with that she got a fright.
Who said that? We will go.
The staff.
Why? Why did they panic?
They wanted to take them on top, third floor.
Okay.
So there, when they reached there on the 16th or 17th, I don't remember properly, there she was okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
You mentioned about oxygen pressure dropping at midnight. What was that?
Yeah, she used to say every night, oxygen is not going down. That bubbling and that level was not going down and she's not getting proper oxygen.
Okay.
The air was not coming. Mommy would complain to her, the air is not coming. Give me some this like when she was feeling something
suffocated
yeah okay. So when she was taken on top again the treatment was good. I don't know why it happened like that. Down it was different and top there was different and they would cooperate. Suddenly she would go out of her this and then they put her on drips, everything they did whatever they could, but it's God wish, nothing else we can say.
So did you ask the doctors when you complained, when your sister complained about the dropping oxygen pressure, what did they tell you?
They said mommy's oxygen level is fluctuating.
Hmm.
So it's going high and low, high and low. So we'll try our level best and we'll try to, even day before yesterday, doctor mentioned that she is okay.
Hmm.
But only within a one day, like her thing came down and I don't know, yesterday when we went to see her, we went inside to see her and she would just make that sound every time, mama will go home, yeah, like that she would say. And then it was only after we went inside, the minute we reached home, we got a message that mommy passed away. She was just waiting for us to see. She was there, but we were not there. But the minute we went there, we got the news in the afternoon that she passed away.
Was your mommy telling you to take her back home?
Yeah, she was saying, but I don't think, because we felt that a hospital would be a better place for her than home. Even we tried to arrange the cylinders, oxygen cylinders at home. For that, doctor said you need a doctor's certificate to buy a cylinder. We went to Arlen, brother went to Arlen. He was getting a cylinder, but the oxygen kit was not available. We called up some agencies. They said after 5 days, you will get it. Then doctor mentioned to her saying that, you know, you read the paper that it is you, if you have one cylinder, the other one you will not get so soon, because like one getting over and then another one you have to have side by side. But it was not possible. We tried to save her, but I don't know, God's wish it is. We have to accept now.
Thank you. So you see, the family tried to get oxygen cylinders from outside. They could manage to get one cylinder, but still they were stopped, saying they needed a permission or a certificate to arrange for the cylinder. Actually, they needed a permission to arrange for the breath of their mother. She needed oxygen. Her oxygen level fluctuated. The hospital was unable to provide her with proper oxygen. The fear of getting her admitted to government hospital. So what is it that people in Goa prefer to die? They prefer to take the risk and stay in private hospital, but they do not want to get admitted into the government hospital. The horror stories from the government hospital continues in Goa. With Santosh Pandey, this is Nazia Sayed for Mojo Story, Goa.
I just wanted to tell something about these people.
Yeah.
It's great to see you here. Thank you for watching our work. If you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to click the bell icon and subscribe to Mojo Story and support independent, robust journalism.